What would you tell someone who's interested in getting into your field?
I'd say love the fact that you are in front of this tool, which is tablet or Cintiq or whatever it is. It doesn't matter what you get as an accolade, as a reward. There will only always be that. It's always your craft, it's always you, your stylist, and what you're making. So as long as you're doing that, you're already doing it. Just keep doing it and you'll get better, and then someone will start to pay you for it.
Okay, so depending on what they prefer, they have to make sure they're passionate about it. Because there are going to be days where they're working, you know, religiously. And if they can't enjoy every moment of it, or at least most of it, there might be a few bumps where it's not as pleasant, then they should look to words, you know, if they don't like that in animation, then maybe do 3D modeling. If they don't like 3D modeling, do 2D art. If they prefer programming, then they should do that. But whatever it is, if they're not passionate about it, if they're not gonna be able to enjoy it, then it's not worth the commitment, because it's a very big one, and you're effectively creating a whole world, right? So it's not a small undertaking by any means.
The advice I would say for getting hired is to try to bypass the digital process and talk to a human. So if you're trying to get a job, you know, like say Mercury Filmworks, find out who the HR person is, and try to talk to them and get your hands, write a really nice cover letter, because I get a lot of applications without cover letters. And you know, do a good job on the resume.
And portfolio, right?
Portfolio.
Proper portfolio, not from Instagram or
don't,
something.
Don't send me an Instagram or a Tumblr. Yeah, so. Send me organized work, 10 pieces at the most. Usually, if you do a good job within the first 3 seconds, you already know whether you want that person or not, and you like bring them in for an interview.
I would try and say, like, when you're applying to studios, find your focus. Keep your demo reel down to about a minute, because they're going to see a lot of demo reels. And start strong, end strong, and know what you're going for. Don't put your 2D and 3D stuff together. Do a 2D reel, do a 3D reel, and show lip sync, character dynamics, and that kind of things. If you're going into other things like layout, boarding, backgrounds, show the focus of those as well.
I would say the biggest thing would be open and be disciplined, which is kind of a little bit of, they're paradoxical, but they're actually not, right? It's kind of always being open to an opportunity, always being open to as many different arts as possible. Don't get like locked. Well, I like comics, therefore I will only look at comics. Or I like concept art, therefore I will only look at concept art. Like, it's, I think the wider range of interests, like if you're interested in, you know, jade sculptures, if you're interested in dance, right? Because there's movement in dance, there's shapes in dance. That, like, it's all, like, I would say try to explore the arts as much as possible. Explore everything as much as possible. Get as wide of a range as possible. And then you've got all of those things that you could actually internalize and then kind of bring that out as your style and your vision of what the world should be. Because ultimately, as a perfect example, it's getting to a point where almost everybody can draw and paint, right? So it's kind of like, what is it that you're bringing that's unique on the table? So I would say explore lots and lots of things, and then the discipline part is just work. Just do it every day. You can't help but get better if you do it every day.
If you would like to learn more about Max the Mutt, or want to pursue a career in animation, concept art, or sequential art, click on the link that the arrows are pointed to in the box below, or go to www.maxthemutt.com.